What's up, ladies and gentlemen? Daily here from Frag Nation, and today I have another episode of Daily Talks for you. Today's topic is going to be kind of one that's near and dear to my heart, and that is multiplayer games that are full priced. In today's day and age, it's definitely not uncommon to see a multiplayer-only game show up from a AAA developer, and for me, that starts to boast quite a large problem. Cue in Rainbow Six Siege, a game that has no single player whatsoever. It does have a bots mode, but they're hardly intelligent, it's hardly fun, and it's hardly a story. It's more of a training mission that progresses into a mission that may or may not be considered a campaign mission, but literally just one. The entire premise of the game just utterly makes me cringe at the fact that people are willing to pay and are comfortable paying $59.99 for a game that maybe has as little content as a game like Killing Floor for $29.99. I would argue Killing Floor, being a better game, has more content and more value at $29.99 than Rainbow Six Siege will have with all of its DLC combined. Not only that, but especially in a day and age where developers feel comfortable making you pay full price for a multiplayer-only game and then making you pay an outrageous price for its DLC, cue in Battlefront. This game definitely shows you how greedy and how utterly terrible some AAA developers can be when you release a multiplayer-only title with four maps, a handful of weapons, and call it a Star Wars game is the day that I call bullshit on the AAA industry. And I did. I think when we're seeing more games like this now is because people are buying into that hype of the multiplayer and they want to try and play the multiplayer so bad that the game will sell itself and then it will die shortly after. It's no surprise and no secret that Star Wars Battlefront has definitely had declining numbers over time, and EA has not released official sales data for that game, only made a couple ambiguous quotes that nobody could really pin them to if they wanted to. On top of that, they also want to release a Season Pass DLC for $10 less than the entire game. So you're getting a multiplayer only game, which has the single player and any co-op content cut from it. Battlefield is a hybrid. Its co-op mode really isn't a co-op mode. Again, it's just wave survival versus bots with a couple CG cutscenes in it. Same thing with Rainbow Six Siege, just a couple CG cutscenes, probably a week or two of game development. And then these developers and publishers want to go ahead and charge you for content additional to the game. When you're not getting a single player campaign whatsoever or any kind of single player mode, you've got to pay for additional content. To me, that content should come at an extreme discount or free, especially if you think of a video game in two halves, a single player and a multiplayer. If you remove part of the game, then you owe the consumer the rest of the game. Whenever it happens to come out, if it's multiplayer only. Now, I'm not completely opposed to multiplayer only games. Overwatch, I just heard today when we did our show, The Codec, that it's at a discounted price. Blizzard seems to understand that $59.99 for a multiplayer only game is unacceptable. They do have a $59.99 game out there. It is purchasable at that price, but it includes other things. But there is a standalone version for $39.99. That is extremely more acceptable and much more pleasing to the people who might be new to a series, might be casual players. And you're talking when games are releasing month after month. I mean, already we're in May of this year and there's been several big budget titles, big AAA games that people want to play at $60 a pop. You're talking paychecks for games nowadays, full paychecks to pick up a couple games that you want to play. And that to me is just unacceptable. And for people that want to play these games, I understand why you do it. It's not necessarily something I think a lot of YouTubers and a lot of people who talk about this subject kind of get confused on. And it's not really something the consumer can help. You're going to want to play the games that other people are playing, and more than likely you're going to save up money and purchase the game that you want to play, and it may be a multiplayer only game, and that may fuel the machine of stats and numbers for these big corporations and companies, but that's where it should start. And it should start with like-minded gamers. The people that are developing the games definitely need to voice their opinions throughout the company itself. Obviously, the person making an asset pack isn't the person setting the price. I understand that. But if more people were to get behind this at a higher level and say, okay, this is not the correct thing to do. Games cost a lot of money. If we're making a multiplayer only game, we need to provide a discount or an option for a consumer to purchase a smaller package because they're not getting as much. Especially in games like Overwatch, I think it's a perfect example because Overwatch seems to be one of the games that after you've played the game a few times, a few different characters, a few different levels, experienced the abilities, what is there new to do? When you're playing a story, you can go back and experience the story again. You can try different ways of approaching the story. You can try different means when you're doing a campaign. For instance, if you're playing something like an RTS game, you can try different types of troops. If you're playing a first-person shooter, you can try alternate paths and things of that nature. There's lots of different replayability in the content provided in a single-player game as opposed to a multiplayer game. You're going to play the same map, you're going to use the same skills and the same weapons, and your playstyle in a multiplayer match doesn't matter as much as it does in a single-player game. So for me, the trend of having multiplayer-only games is something that needs to die very quickly, and it needs to extract itself from the gaming industry. It doesn't necessarily have to be completely gone, but there cannot be as many titles as we're seeing today. There can't be big budget and big named franchises like EA, Ubisoft, Konami, putting out multiplayer only games and charging us the same price as a game with a full campaign and a full multiplayer. You're trying to tell me that the development of just a couple multiplayer maps, a couple multiplayer, we'll call them champions, and a couple maybe design effects and destruction effects cost the same amount as a game like The Witcher 3, which has an incredibly detailed landscape, hundreds of quests, hundreds of items, hundreds of different customization options, little notes of story and lore everywhere. You're trying to tell me that a game like Overwatch or a game like Rainbow Six Siege is a comparative value to a game like Witcher that doesn't even have a multiplayer? That just boggles my mind. It just utterly destroys everything that I think I know about gaming when you can sit here and tell me that a game that definitely took less effort to make and is less content and less quality than another game is worth the same amount. It's just not possible. But that is my opinion. That's why it's called Daily Talks. I am interested to hear what you guys think of multiplayer only games. Do they have a place in this community? Do they have a place in the gaming industry? Do you not like them? Do you like them? If you do, what are some good multiplayer only games that might not be breaking the bank for people who are interested in playing? Let us know in the comments below, and I will see you guys next Friday for another episode of Daily Talks on Frag Nation TV.